Welcome to Shape It Up. I am your host, Nicole Simonin, and I help women over 40 lose weight for the last time. The clients that come to me aren't just losing weight. These women are gaining time. They are using all that time they used to spend thinking about what they're going to eat or searching for what new diet they think is going to work. Once they stop all the food drama, they found they have much more time for doing things that they love and enjoy. Think about how much time you spend thinking about food. Talking about food with your friends, worrying about what you ate. I only know this because I have been there. But what would you do with all that extra time if you weren't worried about what to eat? If you're serious about losing weight and gaining extra time in your day, jump on a call with me and we can talk about what results you're looking for and how to get those results. Go to shapeitupfitness.com/chat to get started. So on today's Shape It Up, I am continuing with the daily Thanksgiving tips. If you are new here, you got some catching up to do. So just go back through the beginning-ish of November. I started doing daily podcasts and I am going to be continuing to give you episodes throughout the rest of the year to help you navigate and jumpstart your weight loss through the holidays. So today is not about creating anything. Today is about peer pressure while losing weight. So when you have decided you're going to lose weight, did you ever notice that all of a sudden, and that's in quotes, all of a sudden, the people you spend time with seem to be putting pressure on you? It could be your favorite aunt who is always asking you to taste her food, or the best is, I want you to try this and will you tell me what you think of whatever food? Holidays like Thanksgiving can bring out this need to please your family and or to act more like your childhood version of yourself, and it tends to magnify it. So psychologists have stated that when we go home, we revert to how we behaved as a child. And yes, even now when we are full-grown adults. So your family views you as the little girl you once were, especially if you've been overweight for a long time and now you've made the decision to lose weight. It's like your family is meeting a whole new person and it's not the you that they know. You would think this is not a big deal. I mean, you're just losing some body fat and you're dropping some inches. But the person you are right now has created the current overweight you. So to lose weight, you need to become a new person. You need to become a different version of you. Depending on how deep you are emotionally attached to family and friends and to your identity right now, will determine how much peer pressure you're going to feel from the people around you. The biggest kicker is, unless you are aware, you will think it's someone else's fault. You will think that it's their fault that you're feeling peer pressure and why you are struggling to stay on track while being around family and friends. So, do you remember the show The Biggest Loser? This was a reality show a couple years ago, the reality show where overweight contestants would compete to lose weight and to become the biggest loser. They would seclude contestants and surround them with nutritious food, 24/7 access to a gym, and celebrity trainers. The contestants would work so hard while they were there. They had minimal distractions. They weren't working, like at a job. They didn't have to take care of their kids or their spouses. They didn't have to clean the house or run errands. What you may not know about the contestants were that sometimes they were on the treadmill for 6 hours a day and barely eating any food. They were isolated from reality. And guess what happened when they came home? They had to deal with all the everyday stuff. Yep, most of them gained all the weight back. And only a handful of contestants have kept the weight off. So why is this? Because they got the workout plan. They got the food plan. It's like cramming for finals. Remember in college? You cannot retain what you've learned if you've only learned it temporarily. So when I was dancing professionally as a ballet dancer, the amount of rehearsal and practice that went into a performance is incredible. Like, unless you're in the dance world or in musical theater or stage, there's a lot of practice that goes on before you see the final product on the stage. And I remember not just physically moving to learn the choreography, but I would also write down the steps in a notebook. Like I even had my own little shorthand of notes, and I would visualize my choreography every night before I would go to bed. And any movement that didn't feel quite right or I just couldn't get was critiqued and evaluated and changed if necessary. But there was no cramming. The Biggest Loser contestants who regained the weight didn't take the time to learn, apply, and adapt to the new version of themselves. When they went back home to all the peer pressure, which had been removed while they were at the ranch for the Biggest Loser show, they couldn't maintain what they had been doing. And of course, who has time to spend 6 hours a day on a treadmill? They learned the how and the what, but they didn't learn the skills to shift their mindset and prepare for reality. This is very similar to quick fix, weight loss workouts, or fad diets. So tying this all into Thanksgiving, you are going to be around familiar people and familiar situations. To become the new version of the leaner you, you need to think and act differently around these people. And it's going to feel extremely uncomfortable and awkward, but it doesn't have to be. This is exactly what I work on with my one-on-one coaching clients. So here's one strategy I want to suggest to you. So notice when you are being asked to eat or do something and you think, this is going to make me go off track with my weight loss goals. That's the first like red flag. You want to be aware of that. What would you typically do in that moment? And then what are other choices that you have available? So let's use Aunt Sally, right? So Aunt Sally's asking you if you would taste her dessert that she spent all day making for you, right? And she wants your opinion. What would you say or do? Is your answer getting you closer to your weight loss goals or further away? All right, I hope you found this episode helpful. I would love a review if you have a moment. Just go down to, if you're listening to Apple, iTunes, you can leave a review there. It would be super helpful. And we're gonna be continuing the Thanksgiving tips all the way up till Thanksgiving. So I will talk to you tomorrow. Have a wonderful day.